Welcome to the Corps Report. I'm Corporal Clayton Filipovich.
And I'm Corporal Lisette Leyva.
Beginning October 1st, 2015, staff sergeants and below will be required to complete both online-based and resident PME courses. Marines will not be able to pick up rank until both courses are complete.
That's a pretty big change to the current system. Why should I have to attend the resident course when I already did it online?
You know, that's a fair question, and I'm sure there's more for Marines affected by the change. In fact, Sergeant Major Barrett published a letter explaining the decision.
A letter is nice, but what if Sergeant Major Barrett came here to discuss the upcoming changes?
Okay, like that's gonna happen.
Yeah, hey Corporal Leyva, let's talk about it.
Thank you for joining us, Sergeant Major. As you can already tell, some Marines may see this as a roadblock to promotion. Why is this training so important?
Yeah, don't look at this as a roadblock. Look at this as we are evolving as an institution. We are putting all of our efforts and we are investing in our most precious assets, the physical, the cognitive, and the moral fitness in the character of the Marine.
So, Sergeant Major, how much of this training is actually new?
Well, we've already instituted and we've started the Lance Corporal Leadership Ethics Seminar, which is done command-sponsored right there at your units. All corporals are also now required to go to the resident corporals course, whether it's at the academy or at their own units. And all of our sergeants now have the opportunity to go to resident sergeant PME. Staff sergeants not only have the opportunity to go to the resident academy, but also the new blended 15-week seminar that we have. And gunnery sergeants through our master gunnies and sergeant majors, they're all going to get to continue to go to resident PME and their seminars.
Will the new training and requirements be a burden on manpower?
We are never going to get to where we want to be by remaining where we are. If you think resident PME is a burden, try ignorance.
Well, thanks for coming out, Sergeant Major. We really appreciate your input.
Hey, you're welcome. I think I'm going to stick around.
Sergeant Major, we typically only have two hosts on the show.
Okay, we'll figure it out.
Okay, I'm going to do like arm wrestle or arm wrestle. All right, let's see.
Right.
Okay.
Maybe.
Two, three.
Oh! Feel better about yourself?
Kinda. This month, the Marine Corps is launching a smartphone app for Android and Apple devices. The new app will allow users to access the latest Marine Corps news and content. The app will also feature push notifications. Tired of constantly hitting refresh, hoping to see a new more admin about, I don't know, let's say promotion list? Well then just relax and let your phone do the work for you.
That's actually a brilliant concept. I believe the Defense Media Activity came up with that.
Sergeant Major, how did a young Corporal Barrett get news about more admins? I mean, were there cave paintings or would Chesty Puller just password at formation?
Seriously, how old do you think I am?
In case you missed it, Commandant of the Marine Corps General Joseph Dumford joined the Sergeant Major on Twitter last month. You can follow them using @GenDumford and @SMMC17. General Dumford wants to hear from you. Tweet at the Commandant and at the end of each month, he'll answer the top two posts. Be sure to submit your questions using #AskCMC.
Sir, you and I should do the Corps Report next month. Smiley face, tweet.
Sergeant Major, here's something I think is a little more your speed.
Seriously? Last Marine standing. Well, I guess that's our show. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next payday, right here on the Corps Report.
Welcome to the Corps Report. I'm Corporal Clayton Filipovich.
And I'm Corporal Allie Beiswinger. After a long summer break, it's great to finally be back. Now, to make up for the wait, we've got two breaking stories for you.
First up, a special purpose MAGTAF deployed to multiple locations in the Middle East became operational today.
The force of about 2,300 Marines will enhance Central Command's crisis response capabilities.
And there'll be an aviation presence too, including multiple MV-22 Ospreys and fixed-wing aircraft.
The Marines will serve on a 7-month rotation, supporting exercises as well as responding to possible incidents.
Now, planning for this deployment began in summer of 2013, and it's not in response to ongoing operations in Iraq or Syria.
Last month, you may have participated in a uniform survey about changing over to brass rank in Woodlands for enlisted Marines and making the Sam Brown Belt mandatory for officers.
Well, the Commandant's decision is in. General Amos decided against both proposals, which means our chevrons will stay black, and for the most part, only the truly motivated will rock the Sam Brown belt. Rah.
Speaking of motivation, on September 29th, about 3,500 Marines joined our Filipino counterparts to kick off Amphibious Landing Exercise 2015.
The training includes multiple field exercises, as well as live fire events and humanitarian projects. The training has helped support peace and stability in the region for more than 60 years.
If you're watching on YouTube, click the link in our video description to learn more.
This Sunday, the Warrior Games kicked off in Colorado.
The Warrior Games is a week-long Paralympic-style competition for wounded, ill, or injured service members and veterans. Since its creation, the Marines have won every single
Chairman's Cup. You can follow the Marine team to their fifth consecutive medal by following hashtag WarriorGames2014.
Remember, you can catch up on everything else going on around the Corps by logging on to our official social media sites.
Thanks for watching, everyone. We'll see you next payday.
Right here on the Corps Report.